Belarusian Video Center presents. Igor Bishnev film from the series The Jungles of Chernobyl, 20 years without the man. The Turtle Valley. It is an old valley. It is about 150,000 years old, and we, the turtles, had lived here all these long years. The time was passing, and forests would grow and disappear. Different animals would come and go. Various birds would fly over and away. We cannot count all the floods, hurricanes, and drafts that zoomed by. But we still live on. And these are our roads, the ones belonging to the turtles. They were made by my most distant ancestors. So many turtles have crawled here since. It happened later, some several thousand years ago, when the man came here and made his roads. The first were invisible paths like ours, the animals. Then the roads were made of cobblestone, paved with asphalt and concrete. Then the man stretched barbed wire along the valley and disappeared. That happened 20 years ago. These barbs are so uncomfortable, but I pay no attention to them. We, the turtles, are not afraid of difficulties. Some more steps and the obstacle is behind. And in front of me are meadows, hummocks, and sand hills. I travel along them from time to time. I'm leaving my native bog and the old bed of the river Pripyat to learn how the world that surrounds me has changed. If there's anything new under the blue sky of the marshy woodlands, the Polesia, and who of the old friends has returned to the Turtle Valley? Look, here's a steep. It was made by the people when the barbed wire appeared in the valley, about 20 years ago. The people were trying hard. They were bringing sand and burying their houses and roads in it. Why? Well, in return, beaters live here. They are my brightest and most beautiful neighbors. The slope on the way to their home, that huge Chernobyl sandpit, is very steep and pretty tough to do, especially for such travelers like me. Yet I can't but crawl by and have a look at this feathered beauty. Actually, bee-eaters are southern birds, almost tropical species. But have a look at this. They have settled here, in our Belarusian valley. The colony is still not big, about 10 to 15 pairs, but it seems to me it is going to grow. They are sitting on their watchtower and catch butterflies, dragonflies, or wasps flying around. Bee-eaters are good diggers. They make their digging in the vertical walls of sandpit steeps. They seem to have been the only diggers around, because there is no sign of people here at all. Do you see this long and deep digging? Not a single predator can reach to the nestlings. What is important now is fetching as much food as possible. This duty makes all the parents common anyway. Well, a dragonfly is a nice thing, actually, but it's high time to leave to start on my journey. The sun has just turned to the dusk already, and I still have to crawl across the village. The people, cars, and dogs used to make it pretty loud here in those days. I would have to move in the night, then. Now it is quiet. Only a long-eared owl guards the house. From whom? Well, when there is some spare time, I would eagerly look in on these strange human constructions. It all looks like an alien world different from mine. As if you are on a different planet. It is empty here, cold and scary. Anyway, such feelings follow any traveling discoverer. A small kettle. Oh, and close to it, the sleepy head. The kettle is quite an interesting thing. Once the owl told me that people used to put such kettles into the oven to cook food for themselves. I think this kettle is a perfect place to have some rest in. Well, I have to be back going. I just don't like visiting long, especially such deserted places. You know, there should be the house here. And one more thing, an advantage about this village is that I am crawling across the road without any fear of a car, a truck, or a wagon to run over me. There has been none for the last 20 years. One more amusement awaits me in the outskirts of the village. It is a sandy steep, just like a slide. I am an elderly turtle, you know, but why not slide down like in childhood? Let's go, gosh, it's cool. I hope this crane didn't notice my thoughtless action, because he's such a bore. is likely to tell all the neighbors that a turtle in her venerable age was sliding down this deep. Well, he must have missed the scene. Or has pretended not to. I have to hurry up back to the bog. This is my native riverbed. It looks beautiful, especially at the nightfall. And this is my acquaintance, Wild Boar. He comes here every evening. Well, so long. Good night. A new day dawning. It is going to be warm and sunny. One more summer day in the reserve. The birds are singing and the insects buzzing. As to me, I'm swimming under the water. I'm swimming and thinking how amazing all the natural phenomena which surround me are. What a wonderful world. The world that has survived after the Chernobyl disaster. Moreover, this world has become even richer. There are animal and plant species around which had never been here before. The rivers became cleaner and the bogs have taken up moisture. Wolves and elks, eagles and herons, lynx and roe deer live here side by side. We, the turtles, live here too. This is our habitat. Look how numerous we are, how many hooves, beaks and wings you can see around. That's true. There was a disaster and the man has left these grounds, but we stayed and we can live without the man. Do we need disasters in order to learn to live together and understand each other? I just don't want to believe in that. This is a turtle valley, a fantastically beautiful spot. Part of the Belarusian marshy woodlands. This is the world of Chernobyl jungles. The world saturated with the waters of the beautiful Pripyat River. Here we live in love and in chime.